Hello and welcome everyone to the week ahead commodity report for the 29th of October to the 2nd of November 2018, presented by myself, Phil Carr, at the Gold and Silver Club. So today, of course, we will be reviewing the price of gold and also crude oil as we go into next week. We've had some big moves in the markets last week, with gold breaking out to 3-month highs as investors have rushed into the safe haven after we've seen global stock markets around the world plunging last week, putting gold on track for its fourth week of gains, with hedge funds and money managers cutting their net sell short position in COMEX gold contracts. Meanwhile, hedge funds and money managers have now slashed their bullish bets in US crude oil over the last week to the lowest levels in more than a year, as US equity markets sold off significantly last week, sparking worries about US energy demand outlook. With that said, oil prices did manage to find some support on Friday, rising into the close on expectations that sanctions on Iran as we go into November will tighten global supplies. So with that, let's move over to the charts and I'll talk you through the levels that we're looking at as we go into next week. Firstly, let's move over to gold, which broke out to 3-month highs on Friday. Gold prices spiked up to $1,243 per ounce on Friday before pulling back to $1,233 into the close on Friday. So gold over the last week, although we've had a breakout here and we are now consolidating at the highest levels in approximately 3 months, we're definitely still staying within quite a tight range here for gold. So last week, the low was at $1,220 and the high was at $1,243, which is just over a $20 range for gold. So we're still really consolidating and ricocheting between these levels of support and resistance. So as we go into next week, the key levels that I would be looking at will be as follows. So if we were to see support come in again at the lower end of this range, so between $1,220 to $1,230, and if we see gold reattempt to break back above the weekly highs here, I'm looking at that very critical level as $1,250 as resistance. That would really be the next major target for gold bulls at the moment. That also resides at where the 200-day moving average meets the weekly pivot. So that's at $1,250 if gold continues to pick up momentum next week and we break above the weekly highs. That said, if we see the price action start to roll over, because we've had several attempts to break above resistance, but we've not closed at that level. So each time we break out to that level, we see a retracement. If we were to see a breakdown and a pullback next week, I would just bear in mind that we seem to have a rising wedge price structure, which is forming at the moment. And if we were to roll over, break back below Thursday and Friday's lows, we could certainly come back and retest $1,220, which could be quite a good level of support if we hold on to that level to buy back into gold. But if it doesn't hold on to that level and we start to roll over and see a more significant pullback, I would look at the levels of $1,218 down to $1,200 and approximately $11 per ounce if we were to see gold pull back. And especially next week, we've got non-farm payrolls on Friday, so we certainly could get some volatility later in the week next week. But I would still look at the range for gold. So essentially, the upper end of that range would reside at $1,250. If we consider that recently gold is moving within about a $20 range, it would likely put support around $1,230. But if we break through that level of support and we roll over, we could then see the price come back down to $1,220. And then, of course, below that, it would be the next previous level of resistance, which could then turn into support around $1,211. So that is what we would look at for gold going into next week. And then moving over to crude oil, we do actually have a technical buy signal on crude oil into the close on Friday. US oil has closed at $67.69 per barrel. We have found support right at the lower Keltner channel here. We have a buy signal also, which is residing around the 200-day moving average. We had 3 days of consolidation here over Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Very significant move over the course of last week as well. So far in the month of October, US oil is down over 7%. And that's, of course, following on from where we saw oil break out at the end of September up to 4-year highs. And since then, we've had over a $10 correction to the downside. But that said, if we have a look at this in terms of actual measured move as well, which is approximately $11 move here, that's 1,100 points. So far, the highs to the lows here, we've seen that correction of 1,100 points, which is quite similar, in fact, to the move that we saw going back to the highs here from July. The correction that we had over August, that was approximately also a 1-month correction as well. That move was 1,000 points as well before we found support at the lower Keltner channels. We found support also bang on the 200-day moving average. The buy signal was similar to what we're seeing at the moment. So I would keep an eye on US oil. If we do break out from this downward trend going into next week, it could also be quite a good risk reward opportunity if we do see some follow through to the upside. If we break above the weekly highs, break above the weekly pivot, and really springboard higher off the lower Keltner channels and where we're finding support at the moment. But I do want to see more confirmation for that, okay? So I'd like to see a bit more technical confirmation, breach above those levels in order to confirm that would be a buy for oil. Otherwise, we could see a similar price action to what we saw last week, which is holding at the weekly highs, rolling over, and then if we were to see the price action for US oil, hold around the weekly pivot and sell off next week. The next major target would be coming all the way back down towards a monthly pivot, which resides at $65 per barrel. So just put the range on oil from Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. And this is really what we need to get confirmation. A break above the upper end of that range, some follow through and also closing above that consolidation from last week. And then we could start to look at buy opportunities on that. On the flip side of that, of course, if we just consolidate, roll over, break back below the weekly lows, then it's very likely the price action would come back down, back towards the June swing lows here and also the August lows as well. And that would target $64 per barrel on a correction like that. To the upside though, if we do find good support going into next week, the next key levels that I would look at would be approximately $68.34 per barrel and above that, approximately $70 per barrel. So as we go into next week, we'll have crude oil inventory data on Wednesday, which you want to pay a lot of attention to if you are trading US oil, and also on Friday, we've got non-farm payrolls as well. So if you'd like to find out more about the exact trades that we'll be taking at the Gold and Silver Club and join a community of successful traders, then the private members live trading room is definitely something for you to consider. As a member of the Gold and Silver Club, you will get access to live trade alerts. Now, those are delivered via WhatsApp, email and SMS. You have access to mentorship, expert advice, in-depth market analysis, and of course, trusted insights so you can know earlier how to act quicker and maximize your return on every trade opportunity. Now, to find out more about the service, all you need to do is go to www.jointhelivetradingroom.com. The link is also below this report in the description. So just click on the link, make an application, and we will get in touch with you ASAP. Also, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way, you will be kept updated with the latest commodity reports.